Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the laboratory with an update on the 1950 Chevy. We're working on the interior and we're working on some other details, as you can see here. I was going to do an upholstery video, but then I remembered I have one in the archives, of course with a different build, but I'm going to walk you through the simple steps once again of how I do it, okay? But before I do that, just let me show you a couple of other things first. Got the dashboard. As you can see, we got the dashboard nice and detailed. Finally got the radio face on there. And the shine. And we've got a nice decal on there. Some pinstriping. So I'm really pleased with the way this dashboard turned out. So I think it's going to be a nice detail in the interior, all of the interior itself. All right. So I also have been working on the parts for the visor. Okay. I think maybe this part will be foiled. I think. I don't know yet. It all depends. I've got the horn and then the pedals for the interior in gunmetal, and they're going to have photo etch covering on some of it. I'm also going to build a stick shift, a custom stick shift, and so we'll see how that goes. Okay, so for the interior, okay. I don't know if you've ever seen professionals upholstering a vehicle, but you know they take their time for the most part, and they for the most part do a great job. They do these templates first, and I'm sure you've seen it on Pimp My Ride and shows like that. But they'll take a template like this, and I'm using tape for this. The interior is already painted. It's going to be in this gray, okay? It's acrylic, and so as you can see, I've got the tape panels done. So basically, then at this stage, all right, what you do is you go to Google and you look for a pattern. In this case, I have found my pattern. It's all these skulls, okay? So the upholstery on this build is going to be these skulls that I transferred. I scaled down, I transferred, and then I made a sheet of it with my printer. Okay. Then the next step. Well, let me show you the other sheet. This is going to be the top part of this is going to be the headliner. It's that skull with the flames right here. Okay, and I'll show you that in a minute, what's going to happen with that. But anyway, you make your templates, then you transfer the templates over to the paper, the printout, as I showed you. Before you do that, though, you need to hit up the, this is an old can of Citadel matte varnish that I had that I like. It's actually a very nice flat clear, and I hit up my sheets here on both sides, the front and the back, okay? And so then what you do is you basically, you take your templates, right? You know that they've now have been cut to size and they're nice and you could probably use tweezers. I just always end up using my fingers. So this is what you do. You remove them from there. And then, of course, you transfer them to your, make sure that everything is flat. You wanna make sure that everything is flat, okay? And then, I mean, if it wrinkles up a little bit on you, that's not a big deal. Okay. So you put it on there. And then with your scissors, you cut it out. You remove the tape carefully. And you've got the template for your seats and for your side panels. So it's a very relaxing process, actually. And I love doing it. I use white glue to apply it. The headliner is about the trickiest part because you have to, this is why I like to have extra body parts. That way I don't slow down the painting process, but I also don't ruin my paint jobs by too much handling. So basically I put tape in there. I traced it with a pencil. Then I cut it out. Okay. And the same thing, you know, well, this is not going to go, this is not going to be, the headliner is this thing right here. Okay. So we are going to find the center, and because we want the skull. Okay. And right there, I should be able to come back in there and cut it out, and I should have a real nice pattern. Nothing happens, as you can see, nothing happens to the image or the paper. I need to let me see here if I could do it, center it correctly. I want to utilize some of that flame. Okay, there we go. That's it. So, you know, this will be ready to cut. You cut, and once again, you remove it. And you apply it with white glue, okay? So that's pretty much it. The other thing that I've been working on is the masking for the windshield, and that's very easy to do because I have a what are these things called? I guess that they're like a stylus, and you can pick these up. You know, it is a stylus. Anyway, with a larger ball here and a smaller one here, but you apply your tape and then you burnish it. It's also a burnisher, right? And you go all along the edges and then you cut with your X-Acto, okay? And what I do is I normally keep these like that until I'm ready to apply it because I don't want anything to happen to the glass. If you remove it and keep the glass around, chances are it is going to get scratched up, and you don't want that. Okay. So anyway, in this case, the rear side windows and the windshield needed to have black trim, you know, all around instead of chrome. And so I did that. And so that's it. The other thing I did, and I don't know if I had shown it to you, was that I finally buffed and shined the model, and you're familiar with this kind of shine. Again, this is a lot of work, but it you know, it pays off. So, you know, you can see the shine there. Anyway, we are ready for final assembly here pretty soon because the chassis is done, everything is done except for the interior, which I'm going to work on between today and tomorrow. So this sucker will be done by this weekend, hopefully, and I'm looking forward to it. A thing about this kit that you always want to remember is once you glue, and you have to glue the side panels, door panels, okay, it's going to be very, very tough to get the interior in there. And so you have to go very slow, and you never glue this part here until the very end after the interior is in, or you're not going to be able to do it. Trust me, we've been there, we've done that. And we've ruined a few of these kits, all right? So, and it's not going to be easy to get it in there, but it's a lot easier than if you glue in that final part by mistake and forget about it, and then you can forget about it. All right, my friends, let me know what you think, and we'll be back with more progress. Thank you so much for your subscriptions, your friendships, your comment, and everything else. I appreciate it. All right, we'll be back. Bye.